Hey, sweet friends, welcome back and welcome if you're new. Today I'm really excited to share some tips and ideas on how to create a relaxing, cozy, and calm home that's put together, that's orderly, that you can actually achieve with your kids at home with you. Now, I know that sounds really ideal, and let me just say, I'll be the first to admit, my house is not clean all the time, you guys. I don't strive for perfection. This is definitely centered around grace and we have to receive it. But there are some really easy methods and tools you can use to create this environment and make your life easier so that you can really enjoy these days, soak them in instead of dreading them. So if you like these kinds of videos, make sure you give this one a thumbs up and let's go ahead and get started. The first thing I recommend when you want to create a clean home, a relaxed space, is make all the beds. Now, if you're like me, I have 4 beds that need to be made in my home on a regular basis. And that can be a little daunting, but just getting in the practice and discipline of making your own bed, encouraging your kids to make their beds, even if it's not perfect, it's okay. Like, it's still picked up, it's still clean, it's still orderly, and we're all practicing a really good discipline that sets us up for success for the entire day. Okay, this next one is a big one, and that is declutter those clutter dumping zones every single day so that it never gets too out of hand. Now for me, that would be my kitchen as a whole, just because of dishes and things like that, mainly the kitchen island, and then also my bathroom countertops. I'm someone that is not the best at putting things away when I get ready, so sometimes I leave makeup out or things like that, and just going in really quick to clean up those areas once or twice a day makes a huge difference. I think in general, just practicing that art of quieting your home, removing knickknacks or items that are just not necessary, letting your house breathe, especially before the holidays, is really important. You can really see the items that you value, what you need, what you don't. It's a great time of year to donate items or sell items you're not using. And that way you can really clear up your mental capacity. You're not as anxious because all of that stuff isn't wearing you down. This next one is for the mamas of littles, but practice a toy rotation. This has been a game changer for our family. I have found that having less toys in a play area at a time actually causes the kids to play more. How ironic is that? They're using their imagination and they're not cluttered down or bogged down with all of the options. That can be really overwhelming, especially for a little one. So maybe let the kids play with like one basket of toys a week, and each week we take them back and let's pick new ones this week, or maybe you really still like this one, let's keep this one. It doesn't have to be a weekly thing. I have friends that pull out, you know, more than one basket. They might have a few bins and they just rotate bins like once a month or something. And you'd be amazed. The kids feel like it's Christmas, like they're getting new toys even though they've had them for a long time. So I definitely recommend some kind of toy rotation. So when it comes to creating a relaxing, calming, peaceful environment, sounds and scents are really, really important. And scents, more than anything, I'm a huge scent person, and I always love to burn candles or diffuse essential oils. I love, especially this time of year, heading into fall, lighting a cozy candle, even in the morning time, just totally sets the tone for the day. And I'm a huge believer in, how do you say it? Smemories? I think that's right. Where you smell something and it instantly takes you back to a place. I have scents like that that take me back to my childhood, and I want to create that for my children. And then sounds. Sounds are also really important. So a lot of the times in the morning, my kids know this about me, I will either play worship music really softly, sometimes even instrumental, just to kind of set the tone, or I love to ask Alexa to play coffee shop music and she'll automatically play like very like calming, jazzy, sometimes classical music that you would hear in a coffee shop. And I have found that to be very relaxing. Along the same lines, this isn't one of my main points, and I'm sorry if you can hear those acacias, speaking of sounds, so loud, I'm so sorry. It's summer here in the South. But along with sounds, one thing that I've been trying to do with my children is when we watch TV, when we watch a show, or when I let the kids have screen time with the TV, I'm trying really hard to play more calming, soothing kids shows. So if you have recommendations for some, leave them down below. For me personally, I have found that I love Little Bear because it's just very calming. The music is classical. The kids really love it. And I've also found that I really love Llama Llama. Those just kind of gentle, easygoing shows that aren't too loud and chaotic. That really helps set the tone in the home as well. If you want your house to stay clean, unfortunately, you have to do laundry every single day. I know some people save all their laundry for the weekend, or you know, kind of let it pile up and have a laundry day, and that's fine. If that works for you, then go for it. But if you really want to maintain that like clutter-free, relaxing environment, you have to do laundry every day and you have to put it away every day. So even if it's just one load a day, that can make a huge difference. I have found when I don't have any laundry, I'm actually more apt to throw a load in, and it's a lot easier to just do one load, fold one load, and put it away. So one really easy way to keep your home clean, to keep it in order, and to just have things functioning smoothly with the kids at home is have a weekly homemaking schedule. Now that sounds really intimidating, I know, and I'm not like a cleaning routine person where I clean this day and I clean this day. This is more of a general guideline where you focus on one main thing per day for the week ahead. For example, maybe Monday is meal prep day. You're doing your grocery shopping, you're prepping your food the best you can for the week ahead, stuff like that, and that's your only main focus. Maybe Wednesday is errand day. That is the one day a week you can schedule all your appointments, you can schedule whatever you need to schedule for your kids, or maybe you need to do some shopping or something like that. That's the day of the week you know you're out of the house running errands. And then maybe Thursday is deep cleaning day, where you're just catching up on deep cleaning that you got behind on. I don't have a cleaning routine. I kind of just clean things as needed because I found that a cleaning routine kind of overwhelms me and stresses me out. But a homemaking routine where I kind of just have a block schedule for the week tends to work a lot better. I definitely recommend having a flex day. For me, that's Saturday, and it's just kind of a catch-all, catch-up day if I got behind on anything week prior. Here's my last tip for creating a relaxing, calm, clean home. Are you ready? Your kids are gonna love this one. Get off of your phone or get off of social media. I know it's kind of unorthodox in this day and age, but I really encourage you, take one day a week, or maybe just take a chunk of hours every single day, whether that's you're not on until noon, or maybe you're not on at all from noon to three, whatever fits your schedule and your life. But I encourage you, carve out some time in your week to be off of your phone. You're gonna be more productive. Your home is gonna feel calmer because you're not carrying the anxiety of the world on your shoulders for once. And you're gonna spend more time with your kids inevitably. And this has been the most game-changing one for my family. I have found if I take one day of the week where I'm not on my phone at all, the home just kind of gets a reset. And so I encourage you to try it as well. Alright you guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it's pretty casual and not what I normally do, but I thought it would be a great way to share just some ideas on how to keep your home clean and in order, how to create a relaxed and calm environment in the midst of all of this chaos that we're going through. And just know that I'm praying for you guys. I love you guys. I'm here for you. And I hope that you enjoyed it. And I hope that it just inspired you and gave you some fun ideas. Maybe something you haven't heard before. But if you did like this video, again, give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you're new. My name's Amy. I'm a stay-at-home mom in the Atlanta area. I have 3 kids. And on my channel, I'm all about homemaking, home decor, and creating a peaceful and calm home that you love. So if you like what you see, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below. And I can't wait to share all the fall decor. Don't worry, guys, it's coming and I'm so excited about it. But I hope you all have a great day and a great week, and I'll talk to you really soon. Bye.